Compass FM, your community radio station, North Canterbury. It was a wee bit sad over the weekend up in Waiau. On the phone we've got Mayor of the Hiranui District, Murray Blank. Welcome to Compass FM. Gee whiz, the loss of the Waiau Lodge Hotel, that was a big blow to Waiau and North Canterbury over the weekend.
Oh, for sure, Kerry. Waiau Lodge Hotel has stood, you know, proudly on the landscape since 1910. So, you know, it was part of the institutional knowledge, I guess, of the community in Waiau. So sadly, all of those good times are no longer able to be had in that old building. And yeah, I acknowledge that it hasn't been used since the earthquake. But you know, the hopes and dreams of a renovation have now been dashed, haven't they? So it's a shock, isn't it, when things like this happen in your community that you care for.
We've got a number of listeners up in Waiau, and they express their absolute sadness at the loss of it. 111 years old, and God, but there is a watering hole in Waiau, isn't there? I mean, we've got to have a watering hole somewhere, don't we?
Correct, that's right. So they're important places for our communities, you know, places where people can come together and share stories. And you know, I know we talk about it week after week after week, but it's actually really important for people to come together and share stories, particularly, you know, when the weather doesn't play a really fair game, you know. So, they're an integral part of our community.
Absolutely, totally agree with that. Now, you've got a program going on in the Hiranui called Finding the Fair Way, and I absolutely love this little sort of exercise that you're doing. Finding the Fair Way, it's to do with your 10-year plan, but you're actually holding it on one or two golf courses to find the fair way. How would you, please explain some of that.
Oh, look, it's a brilliant byline, isn't it, Finding the Fair Way, because it is about how we structure our rates, how we communicate with our community, and finding a way that actually creates a bit of enthusiasm around a long-term plan. And we've had a couple of sessions. We had one last night in Culverton, and we've got one tonight up in Cheviot at the golf club at 6:30. So for anybody who lives in the Hiranui district, you're more than welcome to come along to that session. And then tomorrow night we're having it at the Tin Shed in Amberley, so not at the golf course in Amberley, but in the Tin Shed in Amberley at 6:30. But the theme around golfing and finding the fair way to how to structure our rate within the 10-year time frame is a great little play on words that some of the team at the council have come up with. So it's going well. We've had several drop-ins actually, and I think the tone and the feedback from our community has been really thoroughly thought through and expressed as well. And you know, we're an open door type of council, so we love to be able to communicate with the residents of the Hiranui district,
the locals and the ratepayers. I thought when I first saw the story that you walked in through the main door outside, just behind Charles Upham there, and you grabbed yourself a golf club and you putted all your way around the reception area of the Hiranui District Council. And I thought that would be a great idea with the first hole in the mayor's office sort of stuff.
Yeah.
But great. Whoever come up with that idea, grab themselves a packet of Tim Tams there, Murray, and they're Employee of the Week award winner this week at least.
Oh, I'll absolutely pass that on to Rhea, who has been part of the leader of that process. So we've got a fantastic team of people at the council actually that have been supportive to the process. Developing a long term plan is a huge body of work, and so as governors to our district, we've been working alongside our staff to develop some of the themes and the characteristics that we wanted to take through our long-term plan, probably for six, maybe even 7 months, you know, even 9 months. It's a long, long time that we've been developing this. It's a massive document, and what we're taking to the community is the consultation document with the main themes, but there is hundreds of pages of work on the website that you can all have a look at to understand our purpose and our function and our belief of building resilience to our community going forward.
Good on you. Fantastic. It was only minus one in Amberley this morning. In fact, fact, it was relatively mild compared to most of North Canterbury, -5, -6, -7 every now and again in some parts of it. So you, it's nice to know that you're not up to your neck in the hot pools in Hanmer Springs. They're still on -5 at the moment.
Yes.
But gee whiz, what a great place to be if you were in Hanmer, up to your neck in the hot pools.
Yes, that's right. I mean, we're very fortunate. The hot pools are fantastic. It was -3 when I left home this morning. So, this has been a cold old morning, a cold old frost.
Absolutely. Yep. Mari, I appreciate you coming to the phone. You do this every Wednesday morning at around the same time. Thanks so much, and we'll do it again next Wednesday. Mari Black, Mayor of the Hutonui District. Have a good week.
Thank you very much. Compass FM.